What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another topsy-turvy day in the world of Malamarkets, where we discuss the Pokemon trading card game market in terms of buying, selling, and trading cards. And today, we are going to be discussing a few undervalued, in my opinion, Japanese exclusive Pokemon cards. This is the first episode in a series where we'll be evaluating a lot of different Japanese exclusive cards and look for different opportunities when it comes to buying or trading or even trying to grade some of these cards long term. So really quickly, we've gone over this framework a few times now in previous episodes, but when it comes to finding a valuable collectible, you're obviously looking for popularity, scarcity, condition, and nostalgia. So the combination of all of those things that make it valuable and exclusivity, especially as it relates to Japanese-only cards, fits right in nicely and snugly into that scarcity bubble. That is what gives it that exclusivity, makes it hard to find, makes it highly, highly, highly desirable for collectors. Now, what exactly is an exclusive card? Well, it's not like a version exclusive card when it came to Red and Blue and all the other versions where you had to trade because there were only certain monsters in certain versions. And it's not exclusive as in, hey, I'm Pikachu, Ash decided to play with all his other friends now and I'm jealous. It's not exclusive like that. That's not what we're talking about here. What we're talking about here is exclusive, meaning the cards are only available in one particular place or particular language. And if you're enjoying this video, you find it helpful, please consider subscribing to the channel as well. And yes, so these are a couple different versions of Shining Mew. That is the 25th anniversary Shining Mew. These are all widely available. They're available in different versions, different languages, all of that good stuff. But this would be a version exclusive Shining Mew. So this is Shining Mew, only available in the Korokoro promo from 2001, only available in Japan. You can see some of the stats related to this card here. Clearly looking at that PSA 10 average sale of 3,100, very expensive card, very highly desirable, and it is exclusive. But this is a common one. This is not what we're going over as far as undervalue goes. It's definitely very well valued. And actually, this is on my list of cards to acquire in a minty copy as well. So we're going to go over a couple different cards here, or we're going to actually go through some comps to compare these values to other cards that I think are similar, that are higher value, to kind of show over time where I think the value of these cards will go. So the first card we're going to look at here today is Pikachu Level X. This is an awesome card. First of all, it has Ash on the card too, and actually this picture doesn't really do it justice. It pops. The border is awesome. The holo is awesome. And this is the only Pikachu Level X that was released. It was released in 2009 for the Advent of Arceus movie, and it was only available in a limited print run in Japan as a movie promo. Right now, there are only 230 graded copies of these at PSA or graded by PSA, 149 of them 10s. And right now, the PSA 10 average is about $589. So let's look at these comps here. Like we were talking about with the Level X, there are some of the stats. Over the last calendar year, it's a $589 price, but in the last 4 months, you can tell the market price is increasing, going up above $700. The peak in the last year was about $1,200, and there have been about 13 of these sales online. So now let's go through some comps to kind of compare where I think the value of this card should be going. First is, yes, Special Delivery Pikachu. I know this is not a Japanese-specific promo card, but I just wanted to show something here because this was going for well over $1,000 for a while. That $14,000 max sale, I'm not really sure what happened there, probably just an outlier, but in general about $1,300. But in the last 4 months, the market price of this has dropped to about $850. 166 sales, and there are 3,200 almost graded copies of this card, widely available. That's why that card is dropping. The Scream Pikachu, or the Munch Pikachu promo, very, very popular this past year as well. But again, almost 1,800 copies out there, and this price is still increasing. The max sale I saw for a PSA 10 was about 2,800, over 100 sales, $1,600 price over the last year. In the last 4 months, about $1,800. Again, look at these, you know, unique Pikachu promo cards, but there's a lot of these out there, and this is a Japanese-only one too, so it kind of shows where I think there's some room for growth for the Level X. Now, this is probably the best comparison I have. This was a 2002 McDonald's Holo Pikachu promo card, about 400 graded copies, most of them 10s. Over the last year, this was in the $700 range, but in the last 4 months, about 1,200, and actually in the last 4 months too, it peaked at about 1,900, 27 copies sold. So this is a really great comparison. You see how all of these cards are valued higher than the Level X Pikachu, probably because, you know, the Level X 2009 era, a little bit overlooked, I'd say. And these other two promos are widely available and modern, Special Delivery and the Munch promo. So I think there's a lot of room for growth here based on these numbers for the Level X Pikachu. It's a really desirable card. It really pops. I think this is going to be a Pikachu that as more collectors become aware of it or more collectors get into the Level X's and those kind of mid-series sets, this card is going to come out as a promo, and I think there's a good ceiling for value here. I would say at least kind of where the McDonald's Pikachu is, maybe $1,300, $1,400, $1,500 range. I think that's a good spot for that card in terms of long-term value. The second card now we'll go over here is another Pikachu promo. So in the spirit of including Ash in the last card, this is actually Ash's Pikachu GX. I think this is mostly an overlooked card more than anything else. And by the way, if you're finding this video helpful, please consider subscribing. I would really appreciate it. This was a Sun and Moon Ash vs. Team Rocket deck kit. So it was part of a pre-built deck that you could battle with against your friends, 2017. And that's probably why it's overlooked, because it's available in a deck that was only in Japan still. So that's probably, again, why we don't see as many graded copies here. Now, if you're looking at those numbers, though, a raw card for this, we're not going to do the comps since this is a little more affordable, and I wanted to include some affordable options for you guys as well. So $48 is the four-month average here. That's pretty good for 23 sales, and there's a very high PSA 10 percentage, meaning there's a lot of good copies of this card out there. Now, for PSA 10, the last 4 months, the average has been about $200. That average is actually skewed heavier towards the July sales, meaning it's continuing to go up. That's about $150 difference. Now, we didn't include shipping, tax, total grading costs, but there's a lot of room for margin there. So this is a cool card too. Really low pop for PSA. There are a lot of them out there, most likely, but if this is something that's harder to find in the US, I think there's a lot of room for growth there as well and a lot of potential as a graded card. Now, this last one here, we won't go through too much detail because this is another super, super low pop card. Only 14 tens, 46 total graded. Lugia Pokepark 2005. This was from Pokepark in Japan, and it was actually a promo given to those who rode Lugia's spinning ship. This park was open for a very brief time before moving. There have only been four total sales. So PSA 10, 160 and 1,000, which is crazy. PSA 9, 125 and 135. And the raw card sells for about $39 with about 110 sales there. So seeing that $1,000 is crazy. I think there's a lot of potential for this card too. Again, the raw cost is only $39. A really affordable, easy to pick up Japanese promo card. There's a lot of different places where you can get them. It's even on eBay right now too. So I think those are a couple really great promo cards. The Pikachu one I threw more analysis in because it's already a relatively expensive card. More pop, more comps to actually show. But what are your thoughts on these cards? The Lugia, both Pikachus, both kind of Ash's Pikachus. What do you guys think? If you enjoyed this video, you're gonna love the next one. We're going through an entire Japanese exclusive set that I think is super undervalued as well. And it'll go through comps and all of that fun stuff in the next video too. If you like the style of this video, please comment below and let me know. I'll do some more like this. And until then, we'll see you on the next one.